see such a sight. All the folks from four plantations was invited. And they come. They come trooping thick as chilling when they hear the fife and drum. Everybody dressed their finest. Hush your mouth and get away. I ain't seen no such fancy dressing since last quarterly meeting day. Gals all dressed in silks and satins, not a wrinkle nor a crease. Eyes are batting, teeth are shining, hair brushed back as slick as grease. Skirts all chopped and puffed and ruffled, every blessed seaman stitch. Now if you had seen them with their misters, you couldn't have sworn which was which. Men all dressed up in Prince Albert's swallowtails, ready to take your breath. I can't tell you nothing about it, just all the scene folk yourself. Now who was there? Who you asking? How you expect I'm going to know? You think I stood and counted everybody at the door? Well, old man Barber's houseboy, Isaac, he brung that gal to Lindy James. Her, hanging to his elbow, and him, strutting with that cane. My other Harvey Jones, he got jealous. That seemed to stick him like a thorn. But he just laughed with Vine Carter, trying hard to knock that on. But a person would have noticed from the direction of his look, he was watching every step that Ike and Lindy took. Now Ike, he found a chair and asked her, "Won't you sit down?" with a smile. And she answered up a bowing, "Oh, I reckon it ain't worthwhile." That was just for style, I reckon, because she sat down just the same. And she stayed there. So the freshman put a jaw on some sort of game. Then I heard her saying proper, as she raised to go away, "Oh, you really must excuse me, for I hardly cares to play." But I seen that in a minute with the others on the floor. Wasn't any one of them playing anymore. Coming down that floor, bowing and the swaying and the swinging, putting on the high tone manners. All the time she was singing, "Swing Johnny up and down, swing him all around, fare you well, my dog." Now I had to laugh at old man Johnson. He's cautious now. You bet. He's hitting close on to 100. But he's spry and nimble yet. Now he allowed the house sort of giggling, "Oh, I ain't old. I let you see, there ain't no use in getting feeble. Now you youngsters just watch me." And he grabs old Aunt Maria. She weighed 300 more or less. He spun her around that cabin, swinging Johnny like the rest. Everybody laughed and hollered, "Come on, now swing on, Jim." He swung her too, I reckon, like a youngster. Who would hit him? Now that was better than young Scott Thomas, trying to be so awful smart. You know when it gets to singing and it comes to that there part, it's some lady's new brick house and some lady's garden. If you don't let me out, I will jump out. So fare thee well, my darling. Now he's got that circle around you. You've got to break the line. But that darkie was so anxious, he liked to bust himself trying. He kept on blundering around and fooling till he gave one great big jump. He broke the line and he lit head foremost in the fireplace right plump. That fire in the tree, mind you. I thought my soul I'd bust. I tried my best to keep from laughing, but it seemed like dying. You saw the scene, that man scrambling from the ashes and crying. Did it burn him? What's such a question? He didn't get the time. He sold them ashes and them cinders. Every which way, I guess. And you never did, I reckon, clap your eyes on such a mess. For it surely made a picture, and a funny one to boot, with his clothes all full of ashes and his face all full of soot. Well, it likely stopped the party, and I reckon like as not that it would, if Tom Dwight Manny had happened on the spot to invite us out to supper. Well, we scrambled to that table, and I'd like to tell you about it. What we had, but I ain't able. I'm gonna mention just a few things. I know I had an order. I know it'll start a hankering in your mouth or commence to water. We had wheat bread white as cotton. trying to get in the fall. Can't you stand and hear about it? Suppose you've been and seen it all. Seen them great big sweet potatoes lying by that possum's side. See that coon and all his gravy. I reckon then you'd up and die. Mandy, now, y'all must excuse me. There weren't much upon my shelf, but I've done my best to suit you, so sit down and help yourself. Tom, he laughed. I don't believe in apologizing and professing. Let them take it like they catch it. Elder Thompson, that's the blessing. I wish you'd seen that colored creature clear his throat, bow his head, one eye shut and one eye open. His ears everywhere he said. Lord, look down in tender mercy on such generous hearts as these. Make us truly thankful, amen. Yes, that possum come, please. Well, we ate and drunk our portions and there wasn't nothing left. And we felt just like new sausage. We was most nice stuffed to death. Now, Tom, he knowed how we were feeling, so he had to fiddle around, and he made us clear the cabin for to dance that sucker down. Jim, the fiddler, he tuned his fiddle, put some rosin on his bow, he set a pine box up on the table, mounted it, and let her go. He's a fiddler now, I tell you. He made that fiddle ring, for the oldest and the lamest had to give their feet a fling. Jigs, cotillions, reels, breakdowns, and a waltz or two, bless your soul. That music, wind up them people like flu. Cripple Joe, the old man, he danced that floor from the side to the middle. He threw away the crutch, hopped it. What's rheumatism gets to say? Elder Thompson, he got so tickled that he liked to lost his grace. Had to take both feet and hold them so to keep them in their place. And the Christians and the sinners got so mixed up on that flow. I don't know how they would have parted if the trump had a chance to play. Well, we danced that way and capered in the most ridiculous way till the roosters in the barnyard cleared their throats and crowed for day. Y'all have been there, Bird, but I tell you, everything was rich and prime. Name you some talking. We just had one scrumptious